We're looking at question 19, and it's asking us to begin by graphing the standard square root function f of x is equal to the square root of x, then use transformations of this graph to graph the given function. We are given the given function g of x is equal to negative square root of x plus 2 minus 1. So let's go ahead and start by finding our given points for our parent function. So your parent function is going to be your given function without any of the extra add-ons, like this negative sign in the front, the negative one in the back, or the plus two in the parentheses, or your f of x is equal to the square root of x. So let's go ahead, let's get a t-chart going. Your x and your y values, and some good points to use for your x values with square root or any numbers that are perfect square, such as 1, 0, 4, 16, 25, 36, as high as you want to go. But I'm going to be working with 0, 1, and 4. So we need for our parent function, which is f of x, is equal to the square root of x. We're going to be plugging in our x values into this. We know f of x is actually y. So this is saying y is equal to whatever our square root of x is. So our square root of 0 is 0. Our square root of 1 is 1. And our square root of 4 is 2, because 0 times 0 is 0, 1 times 1 is 1, and 2 times 2 is 4. So now that we have our parent function x and y values, let's go ahead and graph that real quick. So we know it starts at 0, 0. It goes to the point 1, 1. And it goes to the point 4 on the x-axis and 2 on the y. So this is going to be our parent function. And just for fun, I know that if I put 9 here, I'll get the value 3 here. So if you go to 9, you go to 3, I'm about to hit that point, just for accuracy. So now that we have that, let's go ahead and find our transformed graph of our given function. We know for our transformed functions, for our x values, we're going to go ahead and make a t-chart just so we can organize this very well. And I'm going to give myself room so I can make this the way I want. For your x values, those are transforms and dictated by what is inside of your argument. So whatever is inside your argument, in our case, it's x plus 2, that will be what transforms your x values. So we're going to do replace with x plus 2. And our y values are dictated by what's on the outside of the argument, such as this negative sign in the front and that negative one in the back. So we're going to go ahead and put negative times our y value, and our y value is going to be minus 1. So now that we have that written out, let's go ahead and set this up. So for x plus 2, you're going to have x plus 2 is equal to your parent function x value. So in this case, it'll be 0. This will be x plus 2 is equal to 1, and x plus 2 is equal to 4. So when we subtract 2 from both sides, that'll give us x is equal to negative 2. Again, subtract 2 from both sides, x is equal to negative 1. Subtract 2 from both sides, and that's going to be x is equal to 2. Do the same thing for our y value. You're going to have negative times your parent function y value. So the first one's going to be 0 minus 1. Negative times 1 minus 1. And then negative times 2 minus 1. So we know that negative 0 is 0. Minus 1 is negative 1. We know that negative 1 is negative 1. Minus 1 is negative 2. Negative 1 times 2 is going to be negative 2. Minus 1, negative 3. So now we know our new x and y values for our transform table. And that is the value negative 2, negative 1, and positive 2. And the y value is negative 1, negative 2. Negative 3. So now we can go ahead and graph this. Now that it's transformed, we have our points. So negative 2 on the x-axis, negative 1. Negative 1, negative 2. And positive 2, negative 3. So let's go ahead. That's where it starts. So this will go something like that. And that is going to be your transformed value. So this one is your transformed graph.